بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، today we will continue our discussion of Allah's names and attributes, and we will do three names that actually occur one after the other. And those names are Al-Khaliq and Al-Bari and Al-Musawwir. Al-Khaliq and Al-Bari and Al-Musawwir. And the name of Allah, Al-Khaliq, is one that actually occurs pretty frequently as a description of Allah. Allah mentions it at least 8 times as a description in the singular. For example, Allahu khaliqu kulli shay. Allah is the khaliq of everything. For example, Thalikumullahu rabbukum khaliqu kulli shay. That is Allah your Lord, the creator of everything. So the term khaliq as a description occurs many times. As well, Allah describes himself twice in the Quran as the best of those who create, Ahsanul Khaliqeen, meaning that Allah's creation is the best of creation and Allah's khalq is the best khalq. So fatabarakallahu ahsanul khaliqeen. So Allah Azza wa Jal describes himself as Ahsanul Khaliqeen. And of course, in terms of verbs and adjectives, they are in the dozens. Wallahu khalaqakum, Allah khalaqa samawati wal ard. In the dozens, the verbs and adjectives. But the actual name Al-Khaliq as a proper noun only occurs once, and that is in the end of Surah Al-Hashr. And these three names all occur together. Hu Allahu Al-Khaliqu Al-Bari'u Al-Musawwir. He is the Khaliq, the Bari, and the Musawwir. The word Khalq actually has a very interesting meaning. It doesn't just mean to create. No, it means to create from nothing, min adam. To create without having any substance to create and without having a prototype or a model. من غير مثال سابق. So the Arabic term خلق means إيجاد الشيء من عدم. To make something from nothing. من غير مثال سابق. Without having a prototype, without having a model. So Allah's خلق is not like our inventions that we do. Anything that we quote unquote create, not in a literal sense, in a metaphorical sense, anything that we make, we have always two problems that will disqualify it from being actual khalq. Number one, we use the material Allah gives us. We cannot make anything from nothing. We can transfer, we can take some stone and whittle it away, we can take rocks, we can do whatever, carve it out, but we cannot create something from nothing. Only Allah, who is the Khaliq, can create something from nothing. As well, when we create, we need a prototype, we need models, we need to tinker, we need to make version 1, version 2, version 3. But Allah Azza wa Jal does not need any type of prototype or model. So Allah's Khalq is different than our Khalq. And in fact, there is no Khaliq other than Allah. هل من خالق غير الله يرزقك من السماء والأرض؟ Allah asked a rhetorical question. Is there any خالق other than Allah that will give you what you need from the heavens and the earth? There is no خالق. No one can create, truly create, except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What we can do, we can transform. We can take something and mold it here and there and make something into another, but we cannot actually create. Only Allah is the actual creator. And of course, Allah is the creator of everything. Allahu khaliqu kulli shay. Allah is the creator of everything. And Allah mentions that of his miracles is the creation of, and he has a long list in the Quran. At least 10 things are specifically mentioned, and then Allah says generically, I created everything. So for example, Allah says, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Of his miracles and signs of existence is the creation of all of the heavens and earth. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ. Of his miracles is he created you from turab. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. Of his miracles is he created for you from amongst you spouses. And he goes on and on and all. So Allah Azza wa Jal is the creator of each and every living and inanimate object around us. The universe and all that is in it. Everything that it is, Allah is the one and only Khaliq. And of the realities of Allah's khalq is that Allah's khalq does not require any effort. Unlike when we quote unquote create, again metaphorically, we have to physically do something. We have to harvest the natural product. We have to tinker with it. We have to use tools. We have to have designs. We have to physically labor. Nothing we can do except that we have to put in time and effort. But Allah's khalq requires neither time nor effort. إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Allah's creation, Allah wills it into being. And there is no other entity in the entire creation that can challenge Allah in this special, unique characteristic. Only Allah has the power to simply say kun fayakun. And that is of Allah's qudra and Allah Azza wa Jal's khalq. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates when He wishes, how He wishes, in whatever form He wishes. No one can dictate upon Allah when to create, how to create, who to create, and what fashion to create in. So Allah says in the Quran, وَاللَّهُ خَلَقَ كُلَّ دَابَّةٍ مِّن مَّا. Allah created every creature from water. The origin of life is water, we all know. But how did Allah create them? What did Allah make of the creation? فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَى بَطْنِهِ. Some of the creation is crawling, slithering, like snakes. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَى رِجْلَيْنِ. Some of the creation is walking on two. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَى أَرْبَعَ. Some is walking on four. يَخْلُقُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Allah creates as He wishes to create. So Allah has created the creation and made it so varied. So much variety is put in the creation. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, لِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. To Allah belongs the heaven and earth. He creates as He wishes to create. So to some He gives girls and only girls. To some He gives boys and only boys. And to some He gives girls and boys. So in the creation of khalq, Allah mentions, it is my choice what I create and give to you. يَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ إِنَاثَ وَيَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ الذُّكُورَ أَوْ يُزَوِّجُهُمْ ذُكْرًا وَإِنَاثًا. And some, وَيَجْعَلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ عَقِيمًا. He does not give any children. All of this is Allah's qadr. We have to accept Allah's qadr, whatever He has assigned for us. But Allah is the khaliq, and He gifted us even our children. And Allah decides how many, and Allah decides what's gender. And Allah says, يَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah gifts to whomever He wants. It is Allah who is the khaliq. يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. No one can challenge Allah's khalq and Allah's qadr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of course, has created more than what even we can see. We know that there are creations beyond the heavens and the earth. The greatest and the magnificent, most magnificent creation is Allah's throne, the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is something we cannot even comprehend. And Allah azza wa jal created as well a pen. Our Prophet said, the first thing that Allah created was a pen. أَوَّلُ مَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ الْقَلَمُ. And this is the divine pen. And Allah said to the qalam, the pen, write. And the pen wrote down all that is going to happen. And there are things beyond this, as Allah says in the Quran, وَيَخْلُقُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. He has created what you will never know. Allah's khalq is beyond this creation as well. And I mentioned in a series I was giving in this masjid here, that some of our scholars, such as Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, he actually had the very, very philosophical and deep opinion that Allah's creation is infinite. We are not the only creation of Allah. There are other parallel galaxies. There are other khalq of Allah. And there are other maybe messages that they have been given. And we are not the only khalq of Allah, because Allah is khalaq. Allah is the one who continually creates. And Allah Azza wa Jal didn't just create one creation. وَيَخْلُقُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah has created things you will never know. And there are evidences I went into in another class and lecture. But the point being that there are indications in the Quran that Allah has created things beyond what we can even know. As for Allah's names, Al-Bari, it occurs only once as a proper noun. Al-Khaliq, Al-Bari, Al-Musawwir. All three of these, they only occur once as the proper noun together. That's why we're doing them together. The name Al-Bari, of course, it occurs as a description in Surah Baqarah, فَتُوبُوا إِلَى بَارِئِكُمْ فَقْتُوا نَفُزَّكُمْ ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرُ لَكُمْ عِنْدَ بَارِئِكُمْ. Musa tells his people, repent to your Bari. So it occurs as the ifrad, as a singular, but the proper noun, Al-Bari, only occurs once. What does Al-Bari mean? Al-Bari has a number of meanings. Firstly, Al-Bari means to bring out the creation to a reality. So if it is used along with al-Khaliq means to have the plan of creation, and al-Bari' to actually execute the plan. So al-Bari' to bring it out into existence. So this is when it is put together. When they are separate, all three of these names actually are similar. Al-Khaliq, al-Bari', al-Musawwir. But when they're put together, each one takes on a specific meaning that becomes complementary. So al-Bari' becomes, if you like, the execution of the plan. So Al-Khaliq is the one who makes the plan, Al-Bari' the one who then executes it and brings it out into reality. Another meaning of Al-Bari' is very interesting, and it comes from the meaning of Bara'a, or to be different from, to disassociate from. And Al-Bara'a means to be different, to cut off, to dissociate. So one meaning of Al-Bari', and this is a very, very profound meaning, the one who has made the same creation, each one of which is different from the other. Al-Bari', the one who has made the same creation, human beings. Each one of them, miraculously, amazingly, they are all human. 6 billion, or now we're 7 billion. And then we add the people before us and after us, maybe 20, 30 billion. No two of these billion, even though they're all human beings, all the same DNA, the same Homo sapien, the same, yet no two of them are exactly the same. This is Al-Bari'. Al-Bari', the one who can create the creation the same yet differently. And what an amazing, what a miraculous, only Allah can do this. Even identical twins, by the way, we know they're not exactly identical. There are some differences between them. No two humans are exactly alike. How can you create 20 billion of something and no two are exactly alike? That is Al-Bari'. There's a third meaning of Al-Bari', and this is a slightly derived meaning. It's not directly there, but some of our scholars have mentioned it. And that is from the Arabic word bara'a, means to be cured from. So the one who bara'a, he is cured from disease. So Al-Bari' is the one who has created the creation such that the creation can heal itself. Such that the creation, like anything we make, if anything breaks, khalas, is broken. If something breaks from our computer or hard drive or anything, it's not going to fix itself. But every doctor here, every one of us knows, most of our natural ailments and problems, our cuts and bruises, our, what happens? Automatically, somehow, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the creation such that the creation can, yubri'u nafsu, it can take care of itself. It can cleanse and purify itself. What a magnificent creator, such that the creation itself can take care of most diseases, most cuts and bruises. This is Al-Bari'. So Al-Khaliq, Al-Bari'. And then the last one, Al-Musawwir. And of course Al-Musawwir, we all have a vague meaning of what it means, and that is the correct meaning. Al-Musawwir, the one who gives shape, surah, the one who gives shape. And of course, Al-Musawwir, it's as if Allah is saying, I am the Khaliq, the one who has the conception. The Bari, the one who brings it into being. The Musawwir, the one who then fashions and shapes it. So the Khaliq and Bari and Musawwir are all complementary, and yet each one has a specific meaning. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, هُوَ الَّذِي يُصَوِّرُكُمْ فِي الْأَرْحَامِ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ. Allah is the one who fashions you in your mother's wombs, however He wants. So Allah fashions us, our postures, our skin colors, our exact features, they are chiseled by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So يُصَوِّرُكُمْ فِي الْأَرْحَامِ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَصَوَّرَكُمْ فَأَحْسَنَ صُوَرَكُمْ. I am the one who gave you your surahs, your fashions and forms. فَأَحْسَنَ صُوَرَكُمْ. And I am the one who perfected your fashions and forms. So even our shapes, our sizes, our features, our forms, even they come from Allah. And of course, not just us, but the entire creation. Look around you and marvel at the diversity of shapes and sizes. Who made the giraffe so elegant, the gazelle so beautiful, the whale so massive? Where did all these shapes come from? Each and every animal is truly astounding, and it's and the dynamics of its own structure, the bone structure, the exoskeleton, the internal skeletons, every animal's features, where did it come from? The diversity of the surahs that exist are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I have a tangent here, perhaps it's not the best to say on the mimbar, but it's something inshallah well interesting that I myself, we used to watch a lot of science fiction growing up, like the Star Trek and all this, so a big fan of those. And if you look at those movies, not that I'm telling you to watch movies, I'm saying, but when they try to portray aliens, when they try to portray other life species, you find that the human mind cannot even imagine shapes that don't emanate from our world. What is an alien in science fiction except a conglomeration of shapes that we know? Either a small or a large or a dwarf or this. You take the shapes we know, you put them together, and you get alien species. Our minds cannot even envision the shape of another life, much less make it, much less give it life. This is al-musawwir. This is al-musawwir. And that is why Allah's names, al-khaliq and al-bari and al-musawwir, are so beautifully harmonized together. Our creator is the khaliq, who plans and can create from nothing. He is the bari, who then brings the creation into existence and makes each species, each individual of the species different. And he allows every member to heal and to grow and to free themselves of disease. And he is the musawwir, the one who brings out the shapes and the forms and the fashions in each and every species. So then when Allah says, huwa al-khaliq al-bari al-musawwir, how can we not go on and say, lahu al-asma'u al-husna yusabbihu lahu ma fi al-samawati wal-ard wa huwa al-azizu al-hakim. The khaliq, the bari, the musawwir, this is the entity that has every name of beauty and every attribute of perfection. Each and every being in the heavens and earth praises him. How could they not praise him when he is the khaliq and the bari and the musawwir? And inshallah ta'ala, we will continue day after tomorrow. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.